Cybersecurity attackers and cybersecurity professionals. Attackers are individuals or groups who attempt to exploit vulnerability for personal or financial gain. Attackers are interested in everything, from credit cards to product designs and anything with value. Amateurs, these people are sometimes called script kiddies. They are usually attackers with little or no skill, often using existing tools or instructions found on the internet to launch attacks. Some of them are just curious, while others are trying to demonstrate their skills and cause harm. They may be using basic tools, but the results can still be devastating. Hackers, this group of attackers break into computers or networks to gain access. Depending on the intent of the break-in, these attackers are classified as white, gray, or black hats. The white hat attackers break into networks or computer systems to discover weaknesses so that the security of these systems can be improved. These break-ins are done with prior permission and any results are reported back to the owner. On the other hand, black hat attackers take advantage of any vulnerability for illegal personal, financial or political gain. Gray hat attackers are somewhere between white and black hat attackers. The gray hat attackers may find a vulnerability in a system. Gray hat hackers may report the vulnerability to the owners of the system if that action coincides with their agenda. Some gray hat hackers publish the facts about the vulnerability on the internet so that other attackers can exploit it. Organized hackers, these hackers include organizations of cyber criminals, hacktivists, terrorists, and state-sponsored hackers. Cyber criminals are usually groups of professional criminals focused on control, power, and wealth. The criminals are highly sophisticated and organized, and they may even provide cybercrime as a service to other criminals. Hacktivists make political statements to create awareness to issues that are important to them. State-sponsored attackers gather intelligence or commit sabotage on behalf of their government. These attackers are usually highly trained and well-funded, and their attacks are focused on specific goals that are beneficial to their government. Internal security threats. Attacks can be originated from within an organization or from outside of the organization. An internal user, such as an employee or contract partner, can accidentally or intentionally mishandle confidential data, threaten the operations of internal servers or network infrastructure devices, facilitate outside attacks by connecting infected USB media into the corporate computer system, accidentally invite malware onto the network through malicious email or websites. Internal threats also have the potential to cause greater damage than external threats, because internal users have direct access to the building and its infrastructure devices. Employees also have knowledge of the corporate network, its resources, and its confidential data, as well as different levels of user or administrative privileges. External security threats from amateurs or skilled attackers can exploit vulnerabilities in network or computing devices, or use social engineering to gain access. Cyberspace has become another important dimension of warfare, where nations can carry out conflicts without the clashes of traditional troops and machines. This allows countries with minimal military presence to be as strong as other nations in cyberspace. Cyber warfare is an internet-based conflict that involves the penetration of computer systems and networks of other nations. These attackers have the resources and expertise to launch massive internet-based attacks against other nations to cause damage or disrupt services, such as shutting down a power grid. An example of a state-sponsored attack involved the Stuxnet malware that was designed to damage Iran's nuclear enrichment plant. Stuxnet malware did not hijack targeted computers to steal information. It was designed to damage physical equipment that was controlled by computers. It used modular coding that was programmed to perform a specific task within the malware. It used stolen digital certificates so the attack appeared legitimate to the system. The main purpose of cyber warfare is to gain advantage over adversaries, whether they are nations or competitors. A nation can continuously invade other nations' infrastructure, steal defense secrets, and gather information about technology to narrow the gaps in its industries and military. Besides industrial and militaristic espionage, cyber war can sabotage the infrastructure of other nations and cost lives in the targeted nations. For example, an attack can disrupt the power grid of a major city. Traffic would be disrupted. The exchange of goods and services is halted. Patients cannot get the care needed in emergency situations. Access to the internet may also be disrupted. By affecting the power grid, the attack can affect the everyday life of ordinary citizens. Furthermore, compromised sensitive data can give the attackers the ability to blackmail personnel within the government. The information may allow an attacker to pretend to be an authorized user to access sensitive information or equipment. If the government cannot defend against the cyber attacks, the citizens may lose confidence in the government's ability to protect them. Cyber warfare can destabilize a nation, disrupt commerce, and affect the citizens' faith in their government without ever physically invading the targeted nation.